It's the cutting edge of new music and the forefront of rock. It's Audio Inc. with Anne.
Welcome to the Audio Inc. Radio Podcast, featuring interviews with the biggest names in rock and metal, hosted by Anne Erickson.
What's up, everybody? This is Sunny from the band POD. You're hanging out with my girl, Anne Erickson, and listening to Audio Inc. Radio.
Hey, guys, it's Anne Erickson. As always, thanks for being here on the podcast. Really excited to have Sunny from POD here, one of my favorite bands. Hey, Sunny, thanks so much for doing this.
Thank you so much.
Well, you guys are on tour with Buckcherry Lit and Alien Ant Farm. What made you guys want to be part of this tour?
First of all, we've been doing it for a long time. We're all friends, you know what I mean? We've known each other for a long time, so it just seems like a fun summer tour. And it's, you know, four bands, like the whole lineup is, you know, everybody has platinum records, you know what I mean? They have hits, and so it's just going to be a fun night, like, from beginning to end.
So what should we expect from your set on this tour? Will it be just a mix from your whole catalog? Anything new?
We're planning on playing, at least shooting for a few, maybe two new ones. We just, I just finished vocals a couple days ago. I think it's a mellow vibe, you know what I mean? We have mixed up songs from singles that people know to heavy stuff. I mean, we can go out with heavy bands, you know what I mean, and kind of hold our own, but this is kind of more of a mellow summer vibe, so I think we'll pull out, you know, obviously songs that people know, but, you know, some of our reggae songs, or maybe some of our more lighthearted, fun songs, you know, that are just on record that people know. Not trying to get too crazy, but still, it's always, you know, big choruses and crowd participation is always fun.
Awesome. And you guys signed with Mascot Label Group, which is really cool. Does this mean there's a new album on the way?
Yeah, I just finished a couple of days with vocals, so I think right now it's kind of just being all cleaned up and put together, and then once the label and everybody hears it, then we'll go to mixing, and hopefully an album by the end of the year.
That'll be awesome. Are there any artists out there who you would really like to collaborate with on music at any point?
Man, I mean, we've been known to do that. Every album we have, you know, somebody that we idolize and looked up to as kids, you know what I mean? So that's definitely something that we've always had fun doing. And we've had from, you know, just punk rock legends like Mike Mir or HR from Bad Brain to Modest Yahoo before he blew up, you know what I mean? Last album we had Maria from In This Moment on a record. We've always talked about doing stuff with somebody like Sting or Bjork would be awesome. Not too many like new schoolers, you know what I mean? It's more like just giving back to the people that we grew up on.
Yeah, I think it's really cool that you did something with Maria from In This Moment.
Yeah, I thought the song that she was on with us was absolutely amazing.
Yeah, it totally it was, yeah.
Yeah.
So POD, you guys have been rocking it for more than two decades, which I find so hard to believe. What do you think it is about you guys? How have you stayed together all these years? Not many bands can say that.
I mean, we're all brothers, you know what I mean? And we definitely feel fortunate to be doing this. You know, we have a different perspective of the industry and music these days. You know, we've kind of been to the mountaintop and back, you know what I mean? And now it's like, and even we did take off a little bit of time, but it was more just kind of sitting back and just contemplating what we want to do. You know, is it just be a part of this industry and keep the machine rolling, or is it just kind of stepping back a little bit and, you know, making the music we want to make, but also just not being puppets to this whole industry, you know? And that's, I mean, it was a big risk. It was a big risk for us. And so we're, you know, we learned to live with that. You know, it's not like we're on the biggest label and we're just doing everything they tell us to do. It's like, what's the point? You know, I mean, that's why we're a band. We've been doing this 26 years, and it's like, you know, we never really answered to anybody except just, you know, the people that love our band. And so now it's kind of like we just call our own shots of what we want to do, and it's tough. Like I said, you kind of count the costs because there's so many bands that have so much support and are just doing so many, a lot of big things. But you know, there's a lot of stuff that comes with that. And I think for us, we were over that. So now, you know, it's like this tour. We tour with the people we want to play with and we enjoy playing, and the venues we enjoy playing, and put out, you know, albums. when we want to.
This one's always hard, but if you had to name your top five albums of all time, what would they be?
That is so... Yeah, that's way too hard, but some of my favorite. Obviously, Quickness by Bad Brains, Joshua Tree by U2. Oh my gosh. This is way too hard. I would say even like Back in Black by AC/DC. I'm just trying to think of stuff when I was a kid, that Survivor by Bob Marley that I... what else? And then have to be a Police record. Oh man, what's the Police record where they're all three? If you remember?
Oh my gosh, like, I have no idea.
Like orange and blue, just like their face. Oh man, Rangada, something Rangada.
You can just say the Police. A lot of people just pick bands.
Yeah, Police is one of my favorites, and you know, as a young kid, my family was young, and so they were on their AC/DC and Led Zeppelin.
So obviously when it comes to future stuff, you guys will have that album hopefully out later this year. Is there anything you can tell me about the sound or style, anything different about it yet?
Yeah, for sure. We did something different this time. I mean, whenever you hear like POD music, it's not like it's a surprise, because if you listen to early stuff from, you know, even early 90s, We had a DJ, you know what I mean? We were mixing in certain sounds, and we mixed reggae music and punk and hardcore and rock and music and even poppy stuff. So it's not like a surprise, but I think on this record, we worked with a group called The Heavies. And this is the first time that we really kind of went in a studio vulnerable and open for more of a writing session, whereas we've always written our own music before. We still wrote our music, but it was more like we were more open to change, or at least them adding kind of their feel to it. These guys they work with a bunch of pop bands, but they just did like the Dirty Heads, and I think they worked with like Sublime with Rome, and they just have more of a, I'm not going to say younger, but it's just more of a cleaner, kind of poppier tone to it. Mm-hmm. So we went in really open-minded, and then here we are at the end of the record, and we're like, man, we don't even have that many heavy songs, you know? Everything is fun, you know, it's fun. It's experimental when it comes to, like, programming, you know, and some drum loops and stuff like that. And we've done that before, but it was always kind of hidden, you know, whereas now it's like, you know, a whole verse could be just like a electronic bass or a drum kit or something. And it's fun, it's catchy. And I definitely think it's, you know, it's just POD 2018.
Awesome. Well, I cannot wait to hear it. Well, thank you again so much, Sonny. Look out for some new music from POD, hopefully by the end of this year.
Yeah, looking forward to it. Thank you so much.
It's the cutting edge of new music and the forefront of rock. It's Audio Inc. with Anne.
Thanks for listening to another episode of the Audio Inc. Radio Podcast. Subscribe to our channel so you never miss an episode. Get inked online at audioincradio.com. I'm Ann Erickson for the Audio Inc. Radio Podcast.